Straight Up with Martin Ssempa. Listen, we enjoy having a great time with my friend
Daniel Omara.
And before we took the break, we were talking about a few things, in case you're just catching up. We're talking about who is the most infamous woman in Uganda. And we had a chance to do a little helicopter. I mean, we can't go through every woman, but we looked at a few of them. And
we agreed that, what's her name? Conundrum.
Which one?
The Chibwetere lady.
Credonia.
Credonia, yes.
Credonia, that one.
That name sounds like one of those Ebonese titles.
Uh-huh.
You watched Ebonese plays, excruciating Conundrum.
Look at her. She looks real humble,
yeah,
but
she
man,
looks very humble.
She will burn you up.
She shocked us like R. Kelly.
And look at Chibwetere. He looks so sweet. So we looked at that and we came up with an idea of what Uganda's top five infamous women. I don't know what you think. If you have some ideas of who you think are the most infamous women, let us know. We want to hear about them and we'll be able to get to you on my Urban TV Twitter. You can also get in touch on my Martin Ssempa. Let me say it with a proper accent. Martin Ssempa.
Yeah, leave the T out.
Martin Ssempa with the nice. Martin Ssempa. So let me know what you think about the show and also this question of who is the most infamous Ugandan woman. Now we're moving right along, and this issue has really been bugging me.
Mm-hmm.
Ever since this idea of the marriage and divorce law came in.
Oh yeah.
There was one thing that really bugged me: the rape in marriage. And they kept saying men rape their wives. I said, look, maybe some, and it happened. I mean, it may happen very minor, but this could be misused when there is domestic issues. And this last week there was an elderly American grandpa, Harry, and his wife. His wife, unfortunately, was in a nursing home. She had Alzheimer's. She was 77. He's 73. He's a politician.
Mm-hmm.
And he had relations with his wife, who was in this nursing home. And a video was made of this. And when, you know, the man had relations with his wife, and apparently the stepdaughters, when they somehow learned that the man had sex with the wife or the nurse, they said, but this woman has Alzheimer's, you know, she may have forgetfulness. How could she have given consent? So for them, that every time a wife has to have sex with a husband, she must consent. And so they took this old man, 73. Unfortunately, the wife has died, so no, she can't answer. She passed on.
Sad.
So he's in court. And they, this is the video. I want to bring this video up of this issue, where they say that the man had sex with his wife, and they say that he must have raped her because there's no way she could have said yes or no.
Because she doesn't have proper
recourse. Even though she got married to him and said, leaving all others, I give you myself. Let's take a look at this video that has got Indiana and America and other people discussing. Let me pull it up for a minute.
We're 1 week away from trial, but motions are still being contested in the Hancock County courtroom. Prosecutors presented a list of more than 24 motions, mainly on what should or should not be admissible in court. Many centered around what evidence prosecutors believe will be presented by the defense.
I don't think I should be shackled in my argument by what the state wants me to say.
Prosecutors say their main concern is that defense attorney Joel Unick will ask questions of witnesses that could lead to answers that have already been deemed inadmissible in court.
The inadmissible facts don't get disclosed on direct examination. The state's asking for exactly what the rule requires.
It's my intention to rely only on whatever evidence is the record by the time Drs. Rachel Greco and Bender testify.
I'd ask the court to instruct Mr. Unick to ensure his witness is aware of his requirements also.
Other motions talked about include keeping Donna Rahans' alleged desire to engage in sexual activity out of the trial. In prosecutors' minds, this case is not a matter of consent.
This is not a case about consent. It's a case about capacity. Whether a 12-year-old desires to have sex isn't relevant. Whether a passed-out, intoxicated person desires to have sex is irrelevant. And the same is true in this case.
I mean, there is the man, he's dealing with the death of his wife. Mm-hmm. Now his stepdaughters are taking him together with the state to court. And they're embarrassing him, showing videos of when he had relations with the wife. Okay, they show, you know, him dropping some her underwear somewhere. Now, they are saying that because she was a little sick, that she had Alzheimer's, not at least, I should actually say she had Alzheimer's, that she did not have the capacity to say no or yes. Now, where do you draw the line? I don't know if...
I'm not even sure what to say at this point, because I'm still thinking to myself, this could actually happen? Like, you could get into trouble for doing that with your wife in case she forgot. And my goodness, like, the struggle is real. Like, I honestly have no reaction for this one. There's no punchlines going through my head. I'm just thinking, wow, we are in trouble if the law has gotten this serious. Marriage.
Really?
Yeah.
There is another brother in Sweden, a Ugandan. Mm. Again, I don't know if you followed, that was in Bukede 2 weeks ago, on March around 16th there. Again, they had a dispute with his wife. The wife was in that one room, and then they agreed. So let's get together, apparently. And then when they were having relations, somewhere in the middle, after the train has started, it was somewhere, it was somewhere at Namboli or Cross. And then she said, stop the train.
I'm getting off.
But the train could not stop. Because the train, by nature, if you want it to stop, you give it about 5 minute warning.
It takes a while for the train to slow down.
I mean, it doesn't matter, even if you're a VIP convoy, the train will knock you. So anyway, this Ugandan couple in Sweden took the case to court, and unfortunately, the man says, you know, in my culture, the lady somehow said, no, stop, but the man didn't stop in time. And so he was found guilty. Mm-hmm. And they charged him about 80,000 krona. And now the man is, he says, I don't have the money. And then the woman says, no, I want 100,000 krona. I don't know what's the exchange rate.
Me neither. I'm just thinking the shilling is weak. So he's in trouble.
So then the man, he said, Banange munyambe, I mean, this Sweden, to Saba government.
Saba government, yeah, Kenya.
To Saba government, yeah, Tuyambe. Really, you begin to see very unfortunate events when the issue of rape in the law of rape in marriage comes in.
Okay, first of all, me, what I'm thinking is, like you say, trains take a while to stop.
Yeah.
And also at the same time, that's why withdrawal is called coitus interruptus. It's not meant to be interrupted. It's one of those things that's just supposed to.
What was that? What was that? Coitus?
Interrupt us. Like, disrupt the normal flow of things for whatever reason. Now, for you to say stop, you have your, like, you have the right to say, okay, I don't want to anymore.
Yeah.
It's okay for you to say it. Mm. But then we agree to get into this together. We are business partners. Eh? We are running this company
together. There is terms.
Terms and conditions apply. Yes.
That's right.
Yeah.
The body, in fact, for me, the body of the wife belongs to the husband, and the body of the husband belongs to the wife in mutual benefit.
Exactly. Yes.
There's conjugal duties also.
Yeah, and then you cut me short in there. Now, I will stop, but we won't share that bed. Trust me, tomorrow we are going to court. There's an imminent divorce settlement pending. Because. Man, why would you do that to anyone? Do you realize what I'm going to go through after that? The agony.
There's a man in Australia, it's called the case is called the 62nd rapist.
Oh yeah.
Again, something happened.
Something similar happened.
Yeah. Again, it was a trick. Mm-hmm. I mean, biologically, men are the ones designed to fall in the trap of this one.
Yeah. So unfortunately.
Again, they agreed to have relations with the lady, and at the certain mile, she said, stop here. But the train.
The train.
The biological, neurological, biochemical cannot stop.
The whole process cannot be even factory machines can't be stopped instantly when they are printing. Like stuff is being sent out. You can't just come and say, okay, shut down. There'll always be that one paper that went halfway. And it could easily block the machine. So you have to be careful with these things. It's more fragile than people think.
So I have to say this. If we're going to discuss this issue of marriage and divorce law, men's voices need to be there, and we have to put our input into it. Otherwise, we're going to have problems like that.
Well, now you understand why my generation is hesitant to engage in relationships.
Well, that's why we need to make sure the law is biologically, neurologically, physically. It's not only in one side. You can make a law that only caters for the women. Yeah. We need a law that caters for the men. Now, I want to get some feedback in of lovers and haters. I know there are people who love... I mean, I don't know why people hate me.
It's about that time. No, you know, you can't be loved by everyone. This is one thing I love.
Okay, we want to get some feedback. If you have some, let me pull up some of our love and hate. Let's pull up some love and hate stuff here and see what people are thinking about the show, if there is something that's going on. My lovers and my haters, what are you thinking about the show? Let's put up, my producer's going to bring it in here in just a minute. All right, who is that? Namubiru is
looking
directly proportionate to her spirit. Is that too bad? Too bad.
Pastor Ssempa. There's Arabic. Okay. Oh, okay.
And what's that one?
Polly Hayes or Cheng Jolly says, made most infamous woman probably in the world. Very insensitive, mean. I don't know if that's for us or for the maid.
No, for the maid, of course.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Okay, what else?
Just checking.
Okay. I think it's great that the lovers and the haters are not us. We can be able to have people can deflect all the negative energy. But listen, thank you for joining us. This is a maiden show, Ssempa Straight Up maiden show. Going to be same place, Urban, it's part of the family. This is the phenomenon that's happening. Even after the show, we can be able to continue the conversation on our Facebook, on my Twitter page, @MartinSempa. I want to keep getting your mail, both love and hate. We'll be back again, same place, same station. Keep it on Urban. Ssempa Straight Up. Thank you, and bye-bye.
Pleasure being here.
All right, man. It's good to have you, bro. When a love, when a man?
Loves a woman.
Loves a woman. That's a great
misery.
No. Love and joy.
Non-stop entertainment.